Jesus. Let's give him high praise today. Come on, everybody, let's go. This time y'all gotta go.
little baby.
Tis the season to be jolly, joy to the world, the Lord has come. I don't know how you feel about it, but I get joy when I think about what he has done for us. On this day, we are mindful that Jesus is the reason for the season. You ought to be shouting over that, knowing that we have the gift of life and the gift of salvation. On this Christmas day, we wanted to warm your hearts with worship because we're mindful that the wise men came and worshiped, and here it is, they weren't in church. They learned how to worship virtually, and they did it in a manger. No matter where it is that you are, what it is that you're going through, I want you to throw a watch Christmas party. All the family members you couldn't see, all of the relatives that you miss, all of the loved ones who you usually would eat with, on this day, I want you to please share this with absolutely everybody. I want you to chat in the section where it is that you're watching from and one reason that you have to give God glory. I'm telling you, one of the greatest gifts that God has given us is new birth. And new birth is a blessing to the world. It's a blessing to DeKalb. It's a blessing to Stonecrest. And it is a blessing to you. Just the other day, we were able to bless thousands upon thousands with free groceries, trying to combat the greatest level of food insecurity since 1929. The Lord has blessed us because we are directing people literally by the thousands all over the state to go and participate in early voting. We've got two senatorial candidates that I want us to push and I want us to support. New Birth has not taken a sabbatical. Even in the middle of a pandemic, we have refused to panic. As a consequence, I want you on this day to make sure that you are giving a gift to the honoree, the gift to the person in whom we celebrate, and that is our loving Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. On this December 25th, can I challenge every single one of you with a Christmas gift? Think about all that you've spent online shopping, all you spent illegally sneaking into the mall, all of it that you have bought and have wrapped, and what you get ready to pull out the trunk and out the basement and out of the closet. And yet, for the one who was born for us, you've not given anything. On this day, December 25th, I want to challenge every single one of you to give a seed of $25. Right below me is the prompts by which it is that you can give, whether you're giving through PushPay, text to give on our secure website, or you put a stamp on it and you're mailing it to us. I want you to please send it. Let the Savior know that you are wise enough to not be in the presence of the Messiah and not bear a gift. One brought gold, one brought frankincense, one brought myrrh, but all of them had to make a sacrifice in order to bring something to him. I don't know what it is that you're going to give on this day. I'm challenging you at 25. There are others of you who feel compelled to do more than that. Others yet more who can't reach up that high to 25. If when you give the best of your service on this day, I want you to give. I want you to know this. I hope you are cognizant of it. That your greatest gift that we find as manifested through the life of our Master, your greatest gift always comes in the form of a person. I'm telling you, your greatest gift always comes in the form of a person. There are people who God has strategically planted in your life to be a gift to you in strategic moments where otherwise you would have been discombobulated. One of the gifts that God has entrusted to New Birth is our executive assistant pastor. I'm so thankful for him, thankful for his genius and for his stratagem and how God has undergirded him for an anointing to see beyond now, but to take us into the next. He is operating as an apostolic futurist, and I'm grateful. He's been with us now almost 1 year, and I wanted you to be able to lean in and know what kind of a gift we have in our midst and in our presence. Pastor Carlise Lemons is originally from Oklahoma, from Oklahoma to North Carolina, from North Carolina to Baltimore, from Baltimore to California, from California to Texas, and now here in Atlanta. I'm telling you, he's a gospel globetrotter. I'm grateful not just for him, but for his loving wife and his amazing daughter. They've come together as a team to help serve us and to push us into the next level. Our music ministry is going to come and prepare our hearts, our minds, and our spirits for the word of God. And when they would have concluded, guess what? You get to open up the gift of the word of God. I'm telling you, if you don't get nothing else, you're going to get something from on high today that you're going to relish, you're going to celebrate. And here's what I want you to do. I want you to break all protocol. This gift of the word, I want you to re-gift it. So I want you to share it with somebody. Call somebody now. Tag somebody now. Tell somebody now. I got a gift for you. And the gift is the word of God. Get ready for Pastor Carlise Lemons.
Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and be
know that he is Christ your Lord. Why don't you clap your hands wherever you are? God is in the place. I bring good news with great joy. This is the reason for the season. Watch it. Who is his name? His name is Jesus Christ, and we celebrate him today. Can I say something to you real quick? Merry Christmas, family. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays to you. Hug somebody if you have someone in your house. Text someone. Let them know that you love them. I like what Pastor Bryant said, so let's just do it even now. Can you re-gift the gift of ministry right now here from New Birth? Why don't you share, tag, and comment that you are being blessed and watching the live Christmas worship experience. Yet again, I'm Pastor Kylie Slimmons. I'm humbled and honored to serve as the executive pastor here under the incomparable leadership of none other than Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant. Hey, if you love Pastor, why don't you write in the chat? I love you. I thank God for you. You're amazing. Thank you for doing what you do. You're always on the front line. We serve a mighty God, and we are honored to serve under a mighty man of God. I don't know how he has the time to prepare a message. I don't know how he has the time for all the Zooms that he jumps on, but God has given him a grace. And aren't you glad that every Sunday he has ministered a word to you that has spoke directly to your heart? One more time, for those who are in the room and for those who are watching online, let's just clap our hands and celebrate God for our senior pastor, Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant. To my wife and child, Tiffany Celeste and Harley Monroe, thank God for you. I just celebrate you all. Thank you for just being in my life. You all are a gift to me. Listen, I want to pray before we go into the word of the Lord today. I believe that God is getting ready to speak to you, and I pray even now that he that has an ear to hear, that you would open up your ear to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying directly to the church, directly to you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for allowing us to see this Christmas day. The truth is, millions didn't make it, but God, we are able to say we are the one of the ones who did, and for this, we are grateful. Lord, allow this day to be filled with laughter, dear Lord. Allow this day to have new memories and great joy. Be with those even now, Father, who are without family, isolated due to this pandemic. Lord, as the grass withers and the flower fades, we are thankful, Father, because it is your word that will stand forever. Lord, when we don't know what else to stand on, let us stand on your word. And I ask you, God, in this moment to reach someone, to save someone, to touch someone. Wrap your loving arms around someone today. Satan, you have no authority in this moment, for God is exalted. He is the greatest power, and we shall not be defeated. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you, family. We're honored to have this ministry moment with you. If you would be so kind, I would ask you to use your app. If you still carry a Bible, open up your Bible. Go with me to the book of Isaiah, chapter number 7. I want to begin reading at verse number 9, and I'll be reading from the New International Version. And this is what the word of the Lord says. The head of Ephraim is Samaria, and the head of Samaria is only Remaliah's son. You do not stand firm in your faith. If you do not stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. Again, the Lord spoke to Ahaz, ask the Lord your God for a sign, whether in the deepest depths or in the highest heights. But Ahaz said, I will not ask. I will not put the Lord to the test. Then Isaiah said, hear now, you house of David. Is it not enough to try the patience of humans? Will you try the patience of my God also? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call him Emmanuel. I want to close out the series of our pastor he has had us in. It has been phenomenal. I encourage you, if you have not seen any of the past 3 weeks, to join us. But I want to close out the series of Sanctified Christmas Shopping. Today, I want to use as a subject for a thought, people of God, back ordered blessings. That's what I want to talk about today. Back ordered blessings. The challenge brought on by the coronavirus pandemic has upset the retail industry. It has forced stores and malls to temporarily shut. It has pushed companies into bankruptcy court and accelerated stores closure. This year, consumers have spent more time online than in person. According to the chief marketing officer of FedEx, Bree Currie, the spread of COVID-19 in the United States has triggered such an increase in e-commerce that shipping volumes have consistently been at Christmas peak levels since March. Amazon, UPS, FedEx, and the United States Postal Service have all been trying to identify the most efficient way to manage the capacity of service and moving their customers effectively. UPS hired 39,000 permanent new employees and an additional 100,000 seasonal employees for this peak holiday time frame. FedEx added 70,000 new employees. In a recent CNN business article from Chris Isidore, he expresses that the surge in online shopping has reached levels that the industry didn't expect to see until several years from now. And many of us this year have been held up trying to purchase something in person to find out it's back ordered. Whether it's a piece of furniture, a home desk to work from, Lysol, apparel to wear, hand sanitizer, laptops for your children. Come on, can we just be real for a moment? A thermometer. And even now, toilet tissue is running scarce again. This year, there has been quantity limitations on what we can leave with in a store. We've seen out-of-stock signs everywhere, empty shelves of needed supplies, and postponements of distribution. A back order is a product that is out of stock at the moment but is promised to ship once available. Back orders represent either, number one, the supplier has problems, or number two, there is an unusual demand on the supplier. Now, I want you to consider, isn't it interesting when we began to run out of materials and goods? It increased in seasons, watch it here, of global pandemic, of social unrest, of political upheaval and racial tension. Notice, due to the fact of all of the unpredictable and irregularities, the demand of in-person anything decreased, whether it is in-person church or in-person sports events or in-person shopping. But the in-person decreased, but what has cultivated is an unusual demand for online everything. And here it is, it has happened even in retail. I believe, watch it here, that not only has retail experienced an increase of a high online demand, but I believe that there has been an increase for our need for our relationship with God. I have detected an unusual demand in the spirit. Consider how much more you have prayed in 2020. How much more you've thrown up your hands and said, God, if I've ever needed you before, I need you now. The difference is, however, retail continues to run out of supplies. But anytime I go to the Lord, I am reminded that my God shall supply all my needs. I need to tell somebody right now, your God doesn't have supply issues. I'm talking good. Would you do me a favor? Will you write that in the chat even now? My God does not have supply issues. You know, I'm so glad that God's supply is different from man's supply, that you don't have to go to God in person to get what you need, but you can go to God online and he'll will respond to you. You don't believe me? Let me give you the Bible. The Bible talks about a centurion, and the centurion said, God, you don't have to be in person to bless me, but if you could just speak a word to my house. Can I just tell somebody, I am thankful that God is not limited to only bless those in person, in proximity, or even perfect. The Lord can answer those online, those who are walking a thin line. And today, I need you to put your faith on the line. Today, I need you to put your prayers on the line. Today, I need you to put what it is that you want God to do for you online. Maybe it's a scholarship for your child. Maybe it's an expungement of the record. Maybe it's joy in your marriage. Maybe it's a loan to be approved. Maybe it's forgiveness for someone who's been holding the grudge. Maybe it's something that you feel like it can't happen. But God said, if I don't show up in person, will you please believe and trust that I can still do it online? Mm-hmm. There is a moment in Isaiah chapter 7 where we see an in-person problem with an online solution. It's in Isaiah chapter 7. We are thrust into the kingdom of Judah, being invaded by its northern neighbors, Ephraim and Syria. Watch this here. They are teaming up against King Ahaz. Pay close attention. The kingdom of Judah is in the southern region. In the book of the Art of War, military leaders are advised to take high ground because it offers an elevated vantage point in the contrast of valleys, because valleys have limited fields of view. And for many of us, 2020, you can tell the truth, has been a year of unparalleled valleys. Somebody knows what I'm talking about. So King Ahaz is shaken by the alliance of Ephraim and Syria. And to add insult to injury, he is allied. He sees that his allied enemies are north of him. I'm in verse number 9 through 11, and the Bible says this. Watch it here. It says, stand firm in your faith, or you will not stand at all. Watch the rest of the text. Again, the Lord spoke to Ahaz, ask the Lord your God for a sign, whether in the deepest depths or in the highest heights, whether it's high or low, whether it's small or great, ask the Lord for a sign. Somebody needs to encourage somebody else in the online community. Will you do me a favor? Will you talk to your neighbor in the community and say, ask God for a sign? Yeah, that's it. Ask God for a sign. I want you to write it down. Ask God for a sign. Now, I don't want you to miss the text. The text said God is asking Ahaz to ask him for a sign. Don't miss that thing right there. I said God is asking Ahaz to ask him for a sign. Let me repeat that thing and bring it back to you. I said God is asking Ahaz to ask him for a sign. In other words, God is saying, I dare you to ask me. Would you just shout right now where you are, because you just got your word that sets you free. God is saying, I dare you to ask me, because there are some things that you are experiencing that you feel like you can't articulate to God, but God is saying, I've been waiting on you to ask me. I want you to watch it here. Ahaz, despite who you've been, watch this here. Ahaz, despite who you've been and the wrong you've done as a king, God still said, ask me. I want to talk to everybody who's had an immoral year. I want to talk to everybody who has made a mistake. I want to talk to everybody who feels like you can't recover. God says, I know you wrong as all get out, but ask me anyway. What a mighty God we serve. I don't know about you, but I'm glad that in spite of my wretchedness, in spite of my wretchedness, and in spite of my ridiculous choices, God would still hear me. God was letting Ahaz know, despite what you are facing, what's going on in person, despite what you've seen this year, pull yourself together and put an unusual demand on your God. I wish somebody would hear me in the spirit right right now. God would have me let you know today that you need to pull yourself together and put a demand on the Spirit. Wipe the tears from your eyes and put an unusual demand on the Spirit. Nobody got me a gift today. Put yourself together. No one has sent me a text message. Pull yourself together. You're still childless. Pull yourself together. No one invited you over. Pull yourself together. Your bills are mounted like Rushmore. Pull yourself together. The diagnosis of the doctor is still the same. Pull yourself together. You're at a job that demotivates your purpose. Pull yourself together. They don't want to be an active parent in your child's life. Pull yourself together. And God, oh, help me now. God is saying, I want you to pull on me with an unusual request. Can you just hear me in the Spirit? Because whatever is over your head, yeah, is still under God's feet. Can I just say it again? I said, what's over your head is still beneath your God. Would you write that one time? I said, what's over your head is still beneath your God. How do I know? I'm in the text. It was a battle, and what was north of Ahaz was still south of God. And God is trying to get Ahaz to ask him for something that Ahaz was having a hard time expressing. Can I be honest? Sometimes it's hard to ask God for things. But I want to share something with you. Even though it gets hard to ask God for certain things, I want to let you know that God is not obligated to answer a request that you don't have the faith to articulate. Say it again, Lemons. I said, God is not obligated to answer a request that you don't have the faith to articulate. And it is during this season of online shopping, I was able to see that there is a process with your online request. The first stage is whatever you want. I said, whatever you want. You have to put it in the purchase cart. You have to put it in a place that emphatically you say, God, this is what I want. And Jesus one time was having a conversation with the blind man, and he asked the blind man, what do you want for me to do for you? Can I just tell somebody right now, God is not intimidated by your request. In actuality, God is motivated by your request. Can you do me a favor? Can you just motivate God to do something bigger than you? God, help me right now. Listen, I've been a father for the past 7 years now, and I just want to share something with you. I've been a father for the past 7 years now. My child is 7 years old, and she has been preparing for this Christmas season since this summer. She has had no problems with telling her dad what she wants. She has made her list, and she has checked it twice. For this Christmas, she wanted an LOL winter disco. Now, the thing about it is she already has an LOL dollhouse, and I'm trying to figure out why now do you want to, but she got me wrapped around her finger, so I go to purchase the winter disco because I can only get it online, so I don't have to go into the store, but now as I'm looking to purchase the winter disco, I find out that it is on back order. Now, I'm getting ready to log off, but then I found out that back orders means that the shopper can buy the item now and receive it in a future date. I heard the Lord speak to me. He said, Kylie's, this is the process of a believer. He says, after you've paid the price, you'll need the patience to receive the promise. Talk, Lemons. I'm trying to do the best I can. Can I tell you something devastating? Ahaz wanted the victory, but he was unwilling to be vulnerable before God. I need to share with someone today that your victory is connected to your vulnerability before God. It's in verse chapter 13. It's in verse 13. The Bible says that the prophet Isaiah said, will you try the patience of my God also? Will you trust God with your back order? I don't want you to miss that right there, because some of you right now are dealing with issues and you're saying, God, I need to depend on man because you're not showing quick enough. You're not coming around fast enough. And God is saying, can you trust me with your back order? Because there are some things that some of you have prayed 10 years ago and it has not came to pass. yes. And I came to tell you that God is not a man that he should lie, shatter, nor is he the son of man that he should repent. Can I tell you, if God said it, that settles it. Lord, help me right here. Will you trust God with your back order? The Bible says that Isaiah said, will you try the patience of my God also? In other words, will you give God time? And right now, I need you to allow me to minister to someone who feels like you've ran out of time, that you don't have any more time to wait. You believe that you are wasting away as you are waiting on God. But can I tell you, the devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. Your worth is certified in your way. Talk, Lemons. I said your worth is certified in your way. How do I know? Because food is better prepared in an oven. Because your worth is certified in your weight. A Toyota takes 18 hours to build. The Rolls Royce takes 6 months. Your worth is certified in the weight. It takes 9 months to have a baby, but it took 42 generations to have a Jesus, your worth is certified in a way. The Bible said it even better. It said, wait, I say, on the Lord, because it is in the waiting that he strengthens your heart. Can I tell you something? As you wait on God, he makes you strong. Ahaz, he didn't want to wait. Ahaz, he didn't want to ask. And the prophet said, despite the fact that you don't want to wait, despite the fact that you don't want to ask, the prophet Isaiah said, Terrence, God is going to do it anyway. Isaiah shut himself off from God using him. But when you look at the genealogy of Jesus, you'll find Ahaz in the lineup. Lord, help me right now. As I have learned, if you don't let God do it for you, God will do it through you. It is in verse 14. The Bible says, therefore, it was like Isaiah was saying, oh, well, the Lord himself will give you a sign since you won't ask. The Bible says that the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. The first sign was for Ahaz because God was going to deliver the people through the war. The second sign, God was going to deliver the people through a womb. I don't want you to miss that right there. I said the first sign was for Ahaz that God was going to deliver the people through a war. The second sign was God was going to deliver the people through a womb. Let me charge your faith. You are coming out the victor this year, not by how you fight with your hands, but by how he's placed something in your spirit. Can I tell you, what's on the inside of you is greater than anything your hands can put together. Can I tell somebody right now, what God has put on the inside of you is greater than the outside circumstance that you face. The Bible says it better. Greater is he that is within me than he that is in the world. Can I tell you something? You are more than your package. I don't want you to miss right there. I said you are more than your packaging. On the inside of you is resource. On the inside of you is witty invention. On the inside of you is solutions. On the inside of you is creative insight. On the inside of you is business acumen. On the inside of you is strategic thought. On the inside of you is the anointing of God. You are blessed and highly favored. What you carry is greater than your circumstance. In business, when you've purchased an online item, you immediately receive a confirmation correspondence email or letter. And as a believer, you receive a confirmation when you've paid a price. Confirmation is confirmed, people of God, when you've paid a price. God, help me right now. Gold is confirmed in fire. Aaron's rod was confirmed around snakes. The sign of confirmation of our Savior was confirmed through the womb of a virgin. The price Mary and Joseph paid was that they were willing to wait on God, unlike Ahaz. Can I tell somebody, for this sanctified Christmas, after you've paid the price, after you received the confirmation, now You have to track your package. Tracking is the benefit of the customer to see where their package is. But tracking is also for the benefit of the company to see where their product is. Can I tell you right now, there are two type of tracking systems taking place in the birth of Emmanuel. One was King Herod. He was trying to kill and tracking all the boys in Bethlehem and in its vicinity who were 2 years old and younger to be killed. The question that I began to ask Dr. Bryant was, how was Herod able to find those babies? I said to myself, he must have been listening to their cries. I wish I had a church right now. Hear me. The enemy has been trying to kill you because your cry is just as dangerous as your gift. Come on, somebody. I said, your cry is just as dangerous as your gift. That's why the Bible says in Psalms 145 that when I cry unto the Lord, he will save me. I know I can't hear you, but will you do me a favor? Would you just cry out in your house? Would you just cry out right where you are? God, if I've ever needed you before, I need you now. Can I tell you, there was the tracking of Herod, but then there is the tracking of the wise men. The wise men were tracking the star until it stopped over the place where the child was. Can I tell you, what you're carrying is being tracked by your sponsors and your haters. I feel it now. Can I tell you, both parties, after you've paid a price, after you have a confirmation, after you've tracked the system, can I tell you what's next in your life? After you've paid a price, after you received your confirmation, after you've seen the tracking system, can I tell you what comes after your tracking system? After you paid a price, after you've received the confirmation, after you have the tracking system, I said, can I tell you what comes after the tracking system? After you've paid a price, after you received confirmation, and after you've had the tracking system, can I tell you what happens next? It's delivery time. I need to tell somebody that what's been on back order, it's time for it to be delivered. I don't know if it's coming through a wire transfer. I don't know if it's coming through a Cash App, a letter, an email, general mail, two-day shipping, overnight, or same day. But what I do know is it is coming. I wish I had a virtual church that would have church with me right now. Would you do me a favor? Would you write to somebody in the online community and tell them two words? It's coming. I wish somebody would hear me right now. It's coming. Jobs coming. Hope coming. Peace coming. Joy coming. Favor coming. Power coming. Look at somebody in the room right now and tell them, it's coming, baby. Wait, I say, it's coming. You, when it's coming, you need to do a couple things. You need to rehearse it. You need to expect it. You need to believe it. You need to receive it. You need to declare it. You need to embrace it. You need to speak it. It's coming. Can I tell you something right now? God says, I'll only do what you have faith to believe. And the reason why I didn't show up for Ahaz is because he did not have the faith to believe. When I ship things, and they're important, or when things are shipped to me, there's this thing called certified priority mail. It's different when you have certified priority mail, because certified priority mail means that to receive the gift, you have to sign it once you receive it. Can I tell you right now that your gift is a priority? And the only way God is going to give it to you is if you know how to show a sign that you're ready to receive it. I don't know who I'm talking to right now, but I need to tell somebody that your blessing is knocking on your door. And God is saying, I won't release it until you show me a sign. Can I tell you something? Praise is a sign. And when you begin to give God praise, it's a sign that God's going to do. I don't know who I'm talking to, but right right now, can I tell you something? I hear something at the door. Can I tell you something right now? I hear miracles at the door. Can I tell you something? I hear your breakthrough at the door. But God said, I won't let you have it until you sign for it. God, help me right now. Before you get what God has for you, you got to put your name on it. Could you do me a favor? Would you lift your hands wherever you are? And will you begin to declare to God, God, this is a sign that I'm ready to receive. I'm ready to receive it. I'm ready to receive it. I've been around this mountain long enough. Turn northward. I'm ready to receive it. I don't know who I'm talking to, but God is my witness. I know I'm talking to you. This is your time to go to your door. Do you hear what's waiting for you? Do you hear what's coming for you? Do you hear your child getting a scholarship? Open the door. I don't care if it's small or great. I don't know about you, but in this season, I'm not concerned about the packaging. I don't care about the packaging. I just want the gift. If I gotta cry to get the gift, whatever I gotta do. If I gotta stay late at night, I just want the gift. And a lot of people never receive. A lot of people never receive what God has for them, because they're so caught up in the packaging that they don't know how to receive the gift. When Jesus shows up, there's no room in the inn. He's trying to get in, but he can't get in because they're telling him there's no room. The Lord begins to let us know it doesn't matter the rooms they don't let you in. He says, Jesus, you're such a gift that I'll make room for it. He says, I'll put the gift outside and let the prophecy of the word manifest itself that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Can I tell you something? God doesn't have to bless you in a room. He can bless you out here. Don't concern yourself with the packaging. Concern yourself with the gift. I'm not as eloquent as they are. I don't have the experience that they have. They know more people than I do. Their Instagram is more than mine. God says, not by power, nor by might, but by my spirit. What's been on back order in your life is getting ready to be delivered. Receive it now. Deliverance and breakthrough. Healing and truth. Deliverance is coming. I wish I had a song of the Lord. Deliverance is coming. Deliverance is coming. Deliverance is coming. As you sit there on your couch alone with the doctor saying you'll never have a child, deliverance is coming. As your marriage seems like it's falling apart, deliverance is coming. As they've told you that they may not have enough money to put you back in school, deliverance is coming. As that job is talking about downsizing, deliverance is coming. You've not been waiting for nothing. You've you've been waiting with purpose. Deliverance is coming. Deliverance is coming, yeah.
Deliverance is coming.
Receive it now.
Receive it now.
Oh.
Deliverance is coming.
I don't know who you are. Don't know where you've been, but oh, I need to tell you.
Deliverance is coming.
Receive it now. Listen, listen. If you've been a part of this worship moment, I want you to do something as an act of faith. I want you to grab some people around your house, even if they haven't been in this moment. And I want you to declare to those that are in your vicinity, God will do everything he said. God will answer everything according to his will. Right now, I know for a fact someone is saying, I needed this word. I've been hanging on a thin line. I've been trying to get in-person connections. I've been trying to maneuver through this season, and I haven't been able to connect the way that I needed to. Can I share something with you? Even though you haven't had it in person, God has just responded to you online. And everything that's been on back order is getting ready to be delivered. New birth, friends, family, if you receive this word, if you believe that God is not only going to answer, but he's going to answer in abundance, I want you to do me a favor, even now. I want you to challenge yourself. I want you to take a step of faith. Are you with me? Is my faith connected with your faith? Is your faith connected with my faith? I'm not playing games with God. I'm not playing games with you. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to give at either of the next three levels. Do you hear me? I know it's Christmas, but it's his day. I know it's Christmas, but you still have faith for God to show up on some backorder blessings. I want you to do me a favor even now. I want you to sow a seed of, in alignment of the house, I want you to sow a seed of $365. For those who can do it, I want you to do it now. For those who can't, I want you to begin to pray about what God is calling you to do. And for those who are struggling to do it, I want you to trust God right now. $365. At a minimum, 100 of you need to do it right now. You're watching this and you're saying, Pastor Lemons, you are talking to me. Pastor Lemons, you are speaking directly to me. I want you to do it. The second tier, for those who have the faith to open up your gift, I want you to sow a seed of $125. I want you to do it even now. That's what I'm sowing. I'm sowing with you. I am sowing with you. I'm sowing with you. I'm sowing with you. I want you to do it. I want you to do it even now. $125. Pastor Lemons, I listen, that's the least that I can do. That's the least. Come on. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but if you fill in the $500 seed, whatever it is that God is releasing you to sow, I want you to trust God in this moment. Because why? Deliverance is coming. I sow on that thing. I believe that it is.
Deliverance is coming.
Come on, I'm giving you time. I'm giving you time to use your Cash App. I'm giving you time to go to Givelify. I'm giving you time to go to newbirth.org/give. I'm giving you time to do it. But as you sow your seed, why don't you declare it in the atmosphere? Deliverance is coming. listen, that third tier is for those who are unemployed, who have been furloughed, for seniors who are on a fixed income. You're saying, I really want to give, but I'm really tapped out. I want you to sow a seed of $25. Of $25. I got to do it. I got to do it. I got to do it. I need you to trust God. If you're in the room right now and this word is for you, I need you to trust God. Merry Christmas. Your gift is here. What's your gift for Christmas? You. You're the gift. And before we get out of here, listen, I know you've already done it, but for those who have not, man, I love my pastor. I'm gonna tell you something. I love him. He knows I love him. And listen, he's been faithful. He's been here for 2 years now. We haven't even had a real moment to honor him and celebrate him. And you know what? I'm the type of person that I want everybody to be blessed. Right now, in the lower third, I want you to sow a love offering even to our pastor right now. I want you to do it. I want you to do it. I want you to do it. I'm sowing a seed right now of $100. Do you hear? I'm giving all day. I'm sowing a seed right now of $100. Will you match me? Will you meet me? Come on. I want you to do it. Come on, this is a giving season. Jesus is the reason for the season. And the best thing he ever gave us was life. I got to get out of here. But before I leave, how could I offer you all of this and not offer you Christ? Listen, today that you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Friends, this is the best day to give your life to Jesus. As our pastor often says, you know you want to be a part of this church. And he wants to be your pastor. He's a good pastor. He's a loving pastor. He's a kind pastor. Why don't you make new birth your home? Why don't you make Jesus your Lord? I want you to right now follow the prompts that are right beneath me. And I want you to get a part of this fellowship of believers. We are a church that is socially motivated, that is spiritually sensitive, and that is community oriented. I'm excited about what God is doing here. And I'm even more excited about you being a part of the team. And for all of those who are visitors, thanks for hanging out with us this year. But tell your pastor that you have been blessed by New Birth and you have been blessed by your home church as well. We're getting ready to get out of here. We got a few more announcements that we're going to leave you with. I want you to know that Pastor loves you. We love you and we thank God for you. Can I pray with you? Just a simple prayer that our pastor often says at the midst of closing. Would you repeat these words after me? Walk with God and he'll walk with me. Talk to God and he'll talk to me. Listen to God, and he'll listen to me. Build for God, and he'll build for me. Give to God, and he'll give to me. Love God. Why? Because he first loved me. Can I pray for you? God, let everything on back order show up at the door before December 31st is out. In Jesus' name. Amen. I love you, but God loves you best. I holla.
Hey, we'd like to say Merry Christmas and Happy Kwanzaa from New Birth. And now it's time for your announcements. At New Birth, we're blessed to have a great leader and shepherd, and we want to show our love and honor to Pastor Bryant for his exemplary service. So please send your cards, gifts, and donations. Also, you don't want to miss our New Year's Eve service. Thursday, December 31st, 12:30 p.m. and 10:30 p.m. 12:30 p.m. special musical guest, Isaac Kyrie.
Every time I think of her, I'm thinking you.
Also, don't miss at 10:30 p.m. the sensational Kiki Shears. Tell your family, your friends, and your neighbors to tune in. Also, we pray the rich blessings of peace, love, and joy over you and your household this holiday season. Stay safe and remember, Jesus is the reason for this season. And that's gonna do it for our video announcements.